Mixed movement in pump prices set in the first week of April. Gasoline prices will once again go up, this time by 45 centavos. Kerosene, on the other hand, set to be cheaper by a peso and 5 centavos. Diesel will also see a 60 centavo rollback. Aside from pump prices, the cost of cooking gas also going down by 30 centavos to as much as 1 peso per kilo starting today, April 1st. Over in Cebu City, dozens of mountain villages placed under a state of calamity because of dry conditions. Our very own Annie Perez joins us now with that story. Annie, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The Cebu City Council has approved to place 28 mountain barangays under a state of calamity due to the effects of the El Nino. Councilor Joel Garganera, who is the chairman on Disaster Risk Reduction and Management, made the resolution, which was approved in mass motion. Garganera said that the rainfall condition of these areas are way below normal. The rainfall are experiencing way below normal level. The basis for the declaration was a report by the Cebu City Agricultural Department saying that the Butuanon River upstream and the Kotkot-Lusaran River have experienced reduced stream flows. Dam water levels and groundwater due to less rainfall have logged at least 50% of production areas and has also shown presence of soil cracks in agricultural areas due to lack of water. The Cebu City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council also issued a recommendation for the same declaration. The council says they are now looking into implementing immediate measures and interventions to help affected constituents cope with the situation. Under the state of calamity, the city can make necessary purchases to undertake critical, urgent, and appropriate measures in order to mitigate the ill impacts of El Nino. Joey Baclayon, meanwhile, the Cebu City agriculturist, already earlier said that they will propose more hoses, drums, and other means to procure water for the farmers in these mountain barangays. They're also looking into providing alternative crops and other means of livelihood for affected individuals. Cebu City Mayor Michael Rama said that the declaration is a formality, but they already long prepared for this phenomenon. In the past days, the heat index in Cebu ranged from 34 degrees to 38 degrees Celsius, which is already under the danger category. And that's the latest here from Cebu City. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot. Annie Perez there joining us on the line. ABS-CBN's resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas now joins us to tell us more about the extreme heat being felt in parts of the country today. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Most of the country will continue to drizzle this Monday. Yesterday, temperatures in some parts of the archipelago exceeded 38 degrees Celsius for the first time this year. 38.4 degrees Celsius was recorded in Tuguegalau City, Cagayan, the hottest yet this warm and dry season. San Jose Occidental Mindoro, meanwhile, logged 38.3 degrees Celsius. Today and for most of the week, the ridge or extension of a high-pressure area eastern parts of northern and central Luzon, while the warm and moist easterlies prevails over the rest of the Philippines. Pagasa forecast, dangerous level of heat index or feels like heat in some areas. 43 degrees Celsius in Apari, Cagayan and Tataraman, northern Samar, while Pilicamarina Sur and Tambuanga City may experience 42 degrees Celsius. Heat stroke is probable if exposure to such conditions is continued. The public is reminded to wear comfortable clothing, use umbrella or other sun protection, do away from strenuous activities at noontime and afternoon, and hydrate frequently to prevent heat stress. Metro Manila will be hot and dry with no to very little chance of rain today. Afternoon thunderstorms may be experienced in some areas of the country, especially the Ilocos provinces and the northwestern part of Cordillera Administrative Region. The latest on the weather, this is Ariel Rojas. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Ariel Rojas, there joining us on the line. With extreme heat being felt in parts of the Philippines forces some areas to call off classes today. Iloilo City Mayor Jerry Trenya suspended classes today and tomorrow from preschool to senior high school in both public and private schools. The heat index in Iloilo City today reaching 41 degrees Celsius. The municipality of Tantangan in South Cotabato also suspended afternoon in-person classes because of the hot weather. Filipina tennis ace Alex Ayala continues to impress on the world stage as she and her doubles partner bagged an ITF tournament in France. Diane Castillo now joins us with details. Diane, go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. Yes, it was a super victorious Easter weekend for Filipina tennis sensation Alex Ayala and her partner from France, Estelle Cancino. The pair was unseeded at the $75,000 ITF tournament in Bourbouge, France, but they upset the top seeds in the finals, Jessica Ponchet of France and Maya Lumsden of Great Britain, in two close sets, 7-5, 7-6. They emerged champions in the tournament. What was really impressive is that the ranking of Ayala and Cancino are not really that high in doubles. Ayala is ranked 305 in the WTA doubles ranking, and her partner Cancino 146, while their opponents, Ponchet, is ranked 151 and is a regular at the French Open doubles main draw. Her partner Lumsden is also inside the top 100, ranked 77, was a doubles quarterfinalist in last year's Wimbledon. So definitely it was a very, very big upset for the Filipina and her French partner. And for sure, their world rankings in doubles will go up. Now, on their way to the finals, they also had some really good wins. In the round of 16, they beat Celine Nayef of Switzerland and her partner Tombari of India in three sets, 5-7, 6-2, 10-6. In the quarterfinals, they easily beat Appleton of Great Britain and Haverlag of the Netherlands, 6-4, 6-love. And then they had another convincing win in the semifinals against the pair of Kira Pavlova of Russia and Marie Vakeri of Luxembourg, 6-3, 6-3. So this is the second doubles professional title that Alex Ayala has won in 2024. In January, she and her doubles partner, Daria Semisaho of Latvia, also won a ITF W50 tournament in India. Now, the singles ranking of Alex also continues to climb. She is at an all-time high of 171. And the victory this weekend was extra special because it was the birthday of her mom, Riza. So she dedicated the win to her mom. Her dad, Mike Ayala, was also in the crowd alongside her coach, Danny DeRocha. So definitely a very happy Ayala family over the Easter weekend, and some really good news for Philippine sports. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Our very own Dayan Castillo there joining us on the line.